if for some reason chapters are not working, I'm pinning a comment with timestamps to all the settings, so you can just click on what you want to see instead of watching the entire video. Let's start with shadow quality, which to be honest doesn't really give as much as one would expect. I'm recommending high setting here, since lower ones make grass look loose shadows, which make it look a bit out of place. This one surprisingly can boost your FPS a bit, so it's worth setting it to medium for extra 3%, then trust me, you won't even notice any difference in quality. Grass quality is somewhat disappointing, as in on the lowest setting a good chunk of it disappears without really giving you the expected performance boost. I would personally set it to medium since it still looks good at that setting. Reflections are weird. Looking at some screenshots, you might think that I switched medium with high, but I did not. For some reason, medium just looks better on lakes. The only thing that high has going for it is reflections on wet surfaces, but the performance hit just isn't worth it, especially because it rarely rains in this game. On top of that, look at this picture. There are no visible reflections to be found here, but performance gain from going to medium in this spot is around 11%. Conclusion, set it to medium. With Snowtrail quality, you won't really see any difference in performance nor quality while playing the game, just leave it on ultra. Water quality is another one without any visible difference between high and low, so I would just leave it on ultra. You can't turn off anti-aliasing in this game, and even on low it's pretty strong. On top of that, the performance gain is just insane when going all the way down. And trust me, I checked it on 4K, 1440 and 1080p screens, and not even on 1080 with anti-aliasing on low can you see any jaggies. Ambient occlusion is another one that can give you decent FPS boost, but I'm not sure about recommending the lowest setting here since vegetation loses some self-shadowing and might appear like it glows a bit, but honestly, you can only see it here in a direct comparison back to back, but while playing the game, it might be just fine, so even though I'm recommending medium here, don't be afraid to drop it too low. The quality loss from anisotropic filtering is going to be basically unnoticeable in this game, so drop it to 2x for extra frames. Motion blur is honestly headache inducing in this game. Way too strong, and even if there was no performance to be gained, I would recommend turning it off. Overall, with my optimized settings, you can get around 53% performance boost without changing the way this game looks. So apply my settings and enjoy all the frames you can get.